now with just a small delay. I welcome you. Sorry, I can't pronounce your name. Nokubi?
Yes.
Nokubi-san, who will tell us a bit about search engine, full text search engines in Debian, especially when using Chinese, Japanese, and Korean characters, which might be quite interesting for us Europeans. So, Nokubi-san, the stage is yours.
Thank you.
So at first I apologize you guys to my in my fear I couldn't update my presentation, so it was almost same as the Debian Mini conference in this year about 3 months ago, but some status were updated, so I talked about such notes. And the presentation has some Chinese characters, but I borrowed a machine and it didn't have any Chinese characters, so I will be switch my machine in later. So, my presentation is focused as such engines in such engine implementations in Debian. And there are many softwares, and they have some different algorithms. So, I try to describe such algorithms and characteristics differences. And then, by the way, I'm Japanese, and the most important issue is to handle Japanese characters, and such issue was very similar for Asian languages, so I talked about such language issue. Then, I'll describe I'll introduce some packages in Debian. And then, I have... in Friday, I'll talk about another both with talking about documentation in Debian. And so I'll talk about such things in this this session. So, at first, algorithms. There are three major algorithms. At first, inverted index. And second is n-gram. And third is suffix array. And inverted index is most popular method. The method is formally very easy to describe. This example is three text files. File A has a phrase search engine in Debian and blah blah blah. File B has there is a steam engine and yeah, yeah, yeah. File C has Debian social contract. As such, so in this case, the word search is contains file A and file C. And the word engine is contain file A and file B. And so inverted index is such dictionary based index. So index has such a word and a pair of the word and contain file. So people can easy to find which file contains a word. So it's very easy to implement. But it has some problems. For usually Latin language is Latin language usually each word is separated by space or something. But some Asian languages is not. So in such situation, I need to split such words by some another method. And and it's hard to match the part of word. For example, a person want to find all words contains SEA. For such situation, the search engine need to search full words it contains SEA. So it takes more cost, but not impossible. Third problem is how to match the phrase. Default, it's not so hard, but it need to record each positions of words. So, for example, the search was far away in the top, or file C in somewhere, like so then someone want to search some phrase, so the engine need to check such words were traced sequentially. And then I'll describe about n-gram algorithm. N means any numbers, but usually used 2-gram. 2-gram is also called bigram. So I'll describe about the bigram algorithm. This is an example. There is a word Debian and so it will be indexed like left part. So sequentially, two characters will be recorded as the index. So BE and EB, BI and BIA and AN. So and also, such part of word, place of the part of word, are also recorded. So, it be able to match the part of any word. For example, someone want to search BIA. So in that case, the engine checks BI and IA, and it will be placed in secondary. So, so correct phrase are perfectly covered, so it has no search missing. Inverted index was based on what, so some algorithm causes such missing, but n-gram was not. However, it has some problem. At first, it requires many calculation because, for example, in bigram, all phrases were separated as two letters. So the engine need to check all of parts and its place. It take many costs than inverted index. And also, it causes too many match. For example, someone want to search C. So when inverted index, C is search it was recorded as a search, not and C is also recorded as another word, but n-gram was recorded in S and E A. Such words were recorded as exactly same. So the engine was find C and such. So some situation it causes a problem. And third algorithm, suffix array. It is the index is presented recorded as a pointer of a full file. So the example is a file in the word Debian and so suffix array when it considers such data as semi-infinite strings. So it is right side Debian and dropped E Bian. Dropped D E B I N and dropped E B I N and I N A N and N. Such strings semi infinite string. So and then the algorithm is sorted as alphabetical order. So then the index data was like this order: A, B, D, E, I, N, such order. And the data is pointers. So usually it was recorded as 32-bit. So usually the index size is four times of the original file. It's really huge. And advantage is almost same as n-gram. And this advantage is also same. But another characteristic is the algorithm needs to remain the original source. Because usually it was searched by binary search. So, but the index recorded only pointer, so the engine need to check the original source to see. And it costs very expensive about indexing. So this example is very small, but usually the target text would be very large. So semi-infinite strings are very very long, so it need to it need very high calculation cost for sorting. And then I'll describe about an Azure language issue. I already said about inverted index description. Usually it needs to segment each word. So usually Azure language are not separated by space, so we need to segmentation process. And some languages has some variant of word suffix, like Japanese. And also they have many kinds of encodings. In this page, it contains Japanese, but it could be displayed, so please take this integer space is in some Japanese characters, and it was split about four parts, and there are three Japanese words. So there are some methods to segmentation. The most easy way is using Kakashi. It is dictionary-based software, and when some words are matched in the dictionary, it tries to split. And it has most longest words were preferred. Another way is morphological analysis. It is the method is natural language based algorithm. So some words are categorized as noun or verb or something. It is called morphology. So this method is also dictionary based, but it calculates the Japanese syntax, right? So usually bugs were not occurred secretly or many rules there are many rules, so then it was analyzed by some software. So there are two major softwares in open source. First is Jacen, and second one is MeKaB. Jacen only supports Japanese, but MeKaB is designed as for many languages. Jacen has such a syntax rule, but MeKaB is more simplified. So it could be usable for other languages, but it has only Japanese dictionary, so it can currently only support Japanese. So this is also in this way. There are also many Japanese words, but it couldn't be this way. So usually Japanese verbs have very many variants. It looks like stemming in English. Usually, base style is move, and variants are moves or moved or moving. There are also similar things were in Japanese, but it's really complex. Okay, I can prepare to display Japanese presentation date. Please wait a minute. So I usually use Windows with corporate Linux. Okay, yes, it's Japanese word. And then, so it's word suffix example. It is work, it means same as moon, and it is base style, and this is variant. 動かない、動きます、or some other. So, 動かない is same as not move. And 動きます is same as it can move. Such a very... there are very many variants. And it's very hard to split.And another issue, character encodings. encodings is a mapping between a letter and identify code. For usually, many people are using ASCII code. ASCII is maps alphabet large A as a hex for one.The details were described as map page section 5 ASCII. It is very simple, but Japanese character is very large, so I couldn't display an individual example, but it is an example of.Asian character encodings. In this example, Chinese and Korean were only displayed one encoding, but I heard there are many kind of encodings. And Japanese has usually used three types of encodings.The first thing is ISO 2022 JP. It is usually used in email. A second one is EUC JP. EUC means Extended Unix Code. And third one is Shift JIS. The Shift JIS is Also, there are many kind of variants. So, Windows style or macOS style or something. So, it causes very many problems. So, usually search engines need to convert into one encodings.However, some encodings have not same not cover the same character set. So, for example, a character were in encoding A, but not there in encoding B. There, such problem is.Yeah, so, and detection is not, it could be, but not perfectly, because it could be classified by sequence. So, and EUC variants are almost same method for encoding. So it couldn't be classified by languages. So EUC, CN, and JP and KR it seems almost same.And then, Unicode has some issue for Asian people because some letters were mapped into same code point. However, usually, such character was different different figures. So usually Asian people are considered as such differences usually want to map another code, but it has gathered in Unicode. And then I'll describe some search engine implementation in Debian. HTDig is very popular for ASCII or single byte encodings. It is based on inverted index. And it could be able to handle local file only. So remote files like HTTP or FTP or something couldn't be handled. And it's very famous. It has developed it since 1995. The second one is Monogo Search. It has also based inverted index. It also can only handle a local file. And it supports some kind of backend database. So PostgreSQL, MySQL, and SQLite. And it also supports internationalization. And but its Japanese support were required Chasen. Chinese word segmentation software is included, so Chinese character can only indexed by only this software only. And the third one is Swish++. It is also based on inverted index. And it supports very various formats, HTML, MP3, LaTeX, and something. MPC is usually based on ID3 tag. And it supports UTF-8. However, it expects for the word was separated by space, so it couldn't be usable for Asian language. And sorry, it is a suffix array, based on suffix array. And so the algorithm's limitation, it can be only support single file. And it supports two encodings, UTF-8 and EUCJP. But it could be used for EUC, CN or KR. And there are some language bindings, Ruby and Perl and Ruby and Python. And Namaz, it is also based on inverted index, but it supports English and Japanese. So, and it also supports some various formats like Swish++. The difference is such file format supporting is based on plugin, so it could be easy to add another format for support. And this layer, it supports two algorithms, bucket index and unigram. Uni means one, so In that time, I described about bigram. So unigram is split once for one character. And the upstream also SRAYA is developed the hyper-SRAYA, the success of the software. It supports bigram. And it is also it was already installed in Debian. So then this section was considered as another session both, but I try to talk about something. There are some documentation systems in Debian. BWWW, it is web-based Debian documentation system. It supports HTML, GNU info, and man pages. And it works with switch clusters, so it could be it's a full text search, but it's only for English. DHelp is also almost same software, but it supports only users only files in user slash share slash docs. It also works switch transfers. So such software is very useful, but not considered about internationalization, so it is not good for Asian or another languages people. So I consider about what's wrong. So usually there are many files in start in documentation directory, but there are I checked some software and it seems no policy. So if someone want to make some search engine index, so they need to detect language or encodings. It's really hard. Info is also the same problem, and usually GNU info was only supported ASCII characters only. Some files are written in Japanese encodings, but it is also some files are different start by some different encodings. Mapage seems good situation because they are already split by languages. So Mapage is easier to make index with for some languages. So I think I need internationalization policy for documentation. I think there are some methods, I consider about some methods, but it should be good for language prefixing file names. Usually Apache supports such methods, so it will be useful. And GitHub and DWWW were only considered about switch purpose. So I think we need some indexing or searching wrapper software to handle other languages. So I consider about such issue in Fridays of. So I want to join some people about if someone have interest. So in the future we need more integrated documentation system in Debian, like desktop search system, Google or Yahoo or some fancy. I think Beagle seems good for such situation, and Webcam search is also good for personal use. WWW offline software is has such such systems, but it was already the development was already stopped. So I need another software. And so someone tried to make Apache module with Hyper-S3 here. So it could be useful for web proxy and web proxy search engine. Yes, desktop search. GNOME has already have big, but it is based on .c. .c is implemented by Mono, so and currently not supported Asian language, but it has a capability to handle another languages, so it could be useful for this purpose. KDE has not such software, but they announced to implement on KDE4. So for personal use, I consider about such requirements, internationalization and much profile format support and user-friendly front-end. So WWW offline was already supported with HTDGO and Namazu. So it could be useful, but developers already finished. So Namazu also supported Squid file cache format, so it could be also useful. However, Mozilla Firefox, such like big browser, has their own cache systems, but it couldn't be supported. So this presentation I talked about many software in packaged in Debian and implementation. And I talked about some issue for internationalization, and I consider we need documentation policy for internationalization. Sorry, I'm not familiar about English, so it's very. It will be hard to hear. Anyway, the slide was finished. So, if someone have a question, please ask me.
Do you know other issues with the, for instance, languages in the Middle East, Arab or other languages such as Hindi? How they are served with such?
Yeah, I'm not research of national languages, but I have. Your question is another language like Arabian language or Vietnam or something. Another thing. They have almost similar problem like what suffix and one segmentation. So to solve this problem, it requires such languages knowledge. So I couldn't, but there are some researchers in Japan, so he could be solve this problem. If you can to one try that is M17N library. It is matching. It means matchingization, and it is a natural language research as software. So it supports many languages like such another languages. So it could be solve such problem, I think.
So my question was, you've gone through most of the search engines that are in Debian at the moment. With Beagle, are you looking at including documentation or file format searching inside of that? Because it already handles most of those, like for emails and instant messages. Which one are you particularly focused on improving for Debian?
At first, I considered about documentation file in packages, and then I consider to spread about such personal users data. So so I think however, such personal data is considered about such the normal KDEs, such desktop system are considered about it. So,
so the other question I had is, we can already do, since we already have the package, we can already create the index files for searching purposes. We could have in part of the package the index file, you drop it in a location, and rather than having something, say, like locate run every night on a cron job, you just have, once you install the package, you already have the index file built in. Do any of the search engines here lend themselves to that kind of ability to search through multiple files or concatenate multiple files into one large search engine system? So in the Debian package, for example, you might have the how-tos might come with an index already pre-built.
Mm.
So there might be search engine index or something. Have you considered using that idea particularly?
It should be good, I think. But some indexes file were host host bytecoder, so it could be hard to use in another architecture.
You also have a size issue.
Sure.
And, you know, we've already sort of had a history of thinking about splitting documentation in general into separate packages, so this could probably come down on either side of that.
But some of the changes that dpackage is supposed to have in the future is the ability to say, anything installed under user share doc, throw it away, I'm not interested in it. So I kind of think that that size issue won't be such a problem in the future.
Still addresses media size and download times and, gee, you're from Australia, aren't you?
Yeah.
So, I mean, you know, aren't you the guys who wanted our sync and Jesus? No, my point is these all just have to be balanced.
Sure.
I agree, because to me, the greatest use of this kind of search technology is personal search. And I think we don't have a very well-coordinated solution for that right now. I think some of the things that the GNOME and KDE folks are looking at are good steps in that direction, but until I have a good, easy way to find things in the 40-ish gigabytes of my email archive, and to be able to do it, you know, on something I can carry around with me,
yeah.
I'm not happy.
Yeah.
Right. So, got a ways to go.
And
well,
maybe solved by Google.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.